Hello, welcome to this video tutorial on the groups function in Blackboard Learn. Groups will allow you to control a student's access to the content based on group membership. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create groups using the different settings available in Blackboard Learn. Note, the information in this tutorial is geared towards non-global campus instructors. Global campus classes generally have groups created for them, and online instructors may want to skip to the second video about populating groups. Under the control panel, there is a section called Users and Groups. Select Users and Groups and the menu will expand to show options to manage groups or users. Select Groups from this menu to create a group. If you are a Global Campus instructor, you should see a page that has pre-made groups on it. If you are teaching a non-Global Campus course, you will need to create the groups yourself. To create groups, select the Create link. There are options to create a single group or group set. The single group option will allow you to create groups one at a time. Use this option if your groups will have slightly different material or communications options than other groups. The group set options will allow you to create multiple groups at the same time with the same parameters. There are different options for student enrollment. Self-enroll means that students will be allowed to choose the group they sign up for. Manual enroll will allow the instructor or administrator to select which students they want in what group. Random enroll will randomly assign students to groups. When you select your group set or type, you will be presented with the options to name the group. Note that if you've chosen group set, that each group within the set will be assigned a sequential number, so there's no reason to label it group 1. Just label the group whatever title makes sense to you, and the program will assign each group a sequential number. You are also provided a text box to enter a group description. You also have the option to make the group visible or invisible to students. Make sure that the option is set to yes if you want students to be able to view and participate in the group. There are many tools available when you are working with groups, including blogs, a calendar, collaboration, discussion boards, email, file exchange, journals, and wikis. The selected items will automatically be created for each group. Make sure that you choose which items are to be graded or ungraded when you create the group. You cannot retroactively link gradebook items to a group or assignment in Blackboard, so it's important to create the graded items at the same time you create the group or assignment. Also note that the discussion board has an option to allow group members to create forums. If you would like the students to respond only to prompts or forums that you create, then choose the option, Do not allow student group members to create forums. If you select Allow Personalization, then students in the group will be able to modify the look of the group page as well as add modules to it. They will not be able to delete any tools you've selected for them or adjust any scoring schemes you may have created. At the bottom of the page, enter the number of the groups you want to create. Once you have established the parameters you want for your group, select the Submit button in the lower right corner of the page, and your groups will be created. In the second video in the set, we'll discuss how to populate your groups. If you have any questions on the material covered in this module, or anything regarding how to use Blackboard to teach, feel free to contact the experts at the Global Campus for more information at global.elearning@wsu.edu.